What's going on, everybody? It's Ty Smith, Modern Renaissance Man. I got a long little piece of hair sticking up. Anyway, I'm getting ready to do a response video to the Dixie Chicks. If this is your first time to this channel, let me just say welcome. Please do not subscribe until you've seen other content of mine and you like what you see. I do more than just reaction videos. There's a lot of avenues to who I am, hence the name Modern Renaissance Man. So anyway, this came by request of a few people. I'm going to point one out. Lil J said not ready for nice, and then Fisty Splinters also did it, and Jody Davis said it's one of the best, and Shillings Vildilv, however you say that. It's kind of sounding Russian a little bit. But anyway, you guys are the ones that requested I do this one. It's called the Dixie Chicks Not Ready to Make Nice. Here we go.
I'm not sure who they say time heals everything, but I'm still waiting. I'm through with doubt. There's nothing left for me to figure out. I've paid a price, and I'll keep paying. I'm not ready to make nice. I'm not ready to back down. I'm still mad as hell, and I don't have time to go round and round and round. It's too late to make it right. I probably wouldn't if I could, 'cause I'm mad as hell. Can't bring myself to do what it is.
I'm not sure I could. They say time heals everything, but I'm still waiting.
Okay, that was Dixie Chicks Not Ready to Make Nice. So, heartfelt song, good lyrics, good words to it, but, yeah, there's a but. She already is telling you what's going on from the beginning. She's not ready to make nice. Said forgive. And then she said, say time heals all things, but she's still waiting. So, for somebody that would say something like that to me, my question to them would be this. Do you even want to be healed of it? She says she's still mad as H, whatever like that. So that's what I'm saying. If you, someone like that, if you continue to stay that way and be that way, then you just going to end up, you are that way, if y'all get what I'm saying. Like I said, it's a good video. It seemed like there was a definite abuse in there. It almost seemed like they was talking about stuff that went on in the Catholic Church or something like that. And I might be wrong in that, but it just, or like something that went on in like a, I didn't mean to say Catholic Church. I meant like a darn, what do you call those places where people get locked up in the straight coat jacket, the Salem, like something happened to her psychologically now, a mental institution, not a Catholic Church. Oh my God, what was I thinking? I think in the beginning, I automatically assumed that those people were like some nuns or something like that. So that's probably what got me. And it looked like something out. Excuse me, a little burp. It looked like something out of Handmaiden. So anyway, it was a nice song, but the title says it all. She's not ready to make nice. So what can you do for a person that's not ready? What can you say to them? It's just, I guess you just gotta let them be. And to that person, they said time heals all things. And she said, well, she's still waiting. Well, she's letting you know, time hasn't healed her yet. She's still waiting. So some people need more time than others. So an example I give that I use a lot of times is that whenever we get done having patients and all that, and we have a surgery done in their knee or in the hip, when we go in to see them, they always ask me, man, when am I going to heal? And I say, you know, the severity of what you went through, it could be things inside your knee or your hip that's torn up before we got to it and fixed it. So there's a lot of damage versus there could be somebody else to where they had minimum damage in their hip or their knee. And we do a knee replacement or a hip replacement. And when we go and treat them and rehab them back, some people say, well, how come mine took longer than theirs? We had the same thing done. Well, you might have a lot more stuff inside your knee or your hip that was tore up more than what theirs was. So that's why they recovered a little faster than yours. Y'all get what I'm getting at? It's as simple as this. Yeah, time does heal all things. But depending on how messed up your inside was, depending on how messed up that hip and that knee, I try to say hip and knee at the same time, depends on how messed up that hip or that knee was, that might elope for a longer time to heal. And she said it's not ready. So it'd be the same thing. Somebody could come to me and say, man, tie my knee. You know, it's been 12 weeks. You know, am I ready? And I'll look at it. Let's see. Do these tests. Do these for me. You're not quite there yet. So I do the same thing. You know, I'm serious. As far as physical therapy go, I do the same thing when I deal with people a lot of times when it comes to a lot of mental things, is that I test them on certain things. See, y'all might think I'm crazy for this, but to actually know it, if you actually conquered or gotten over something, a lot of times is to actually place yourself right in the situation. Now, disclaimer here, I'm not sitting here saying if you've been abused and raped or anything like that, you just go put yourself in front of somebody that raped you. And I'm not saying nothing stupid like that, because there will be people on here that will try to bash me for that. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying mental-wise, to know that you've been over that, to know that you don't have, even with some of my patients that I deal with and I help with post-traumatic stress disorder, a lot of times we have to get them to a certain healing level, and then we'll try to put them into a simulated situation to make them face it, to help them get over it. Because sometimes people don't even know, it can just trigger them, and then boom, they snap. They're not quite ready yet, so we got a little bit more work to do. So anyway, that's what I'm kind of getting at, if y'all understand me, especially with the hip and the knee analogy right there. Time does heal all things. Now, also with that too, a lot of my patients can prevent themselves from healing because they do things we tell them not to do. We tell them, don't do this, don't do that, don't squat below 90 degrees, you know, don't internally rotate your hip, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And sometimes they do it, and they cause themselves harm, and now the healing process takes longer. So, like in this video, you heard her say things like, she said, you know, she ain't ready to forgive. So now it's like, well, it's going to take a longer time to heal then, you know. But you don't understand what I went through. No, you're right. I don't understand what you went through. But all I'm simply telling you this, as far as healing goes, as far as scarring goes, you still got an open wound right there. And if you continue to do things to keep that wound open, you can possibly develop an infection. You can possibly bleed out, and it ends up being the very thing that kills you. I'm talking about mentally too, people. That's why I'm giving y'all a physical analogy, but I'm talking about mental wise. So anyway, I'm going to keep this thing rolling. This is Ty Smith, Modern Renaissance Man. I hope you guys all have food, shelter, and clothing. And most of all, I hope and pray that every last one of you guys are in great health. God bless you all in Jesus' name.